This is a review of landmark papers on umbilical hernia from the East Landmark Papers online resource. This paper, published in 1975, is one of the first manuscripts to describe the management of umbilical hernias in patients with cirrhosis and ascites. 35 male patients aged 35 to 76 years with cirrhosis were included. 27, or 77%, had moderate to massive ascites. 19 patients underwent an elective operation. The type of anesthesia varied and included cyclopropane, halothane, nitrous oxide, spinal, and local anesthetic. All anesthesia was administered to achieve a minimal depth required for abdominal relaxation. The surgical repair consisted of ellipsing the skin around the necrotic portion of the hernia, closing the peritoneum with running chromic suture, and transverse imbrication of fascial layers in 28 patients, linear imbrication in 1 patient, and transverse approximation only in 6 patients. Fascial closure was done with non-absorbable suture. Skin was closed with simple interrupted stitches. In this series, 19 patients were hospitalized for a week or more prior to surgery for optimization. There were 6 deaths and 8 major complications in the immediate post-op period. Time of death was noted to be between 1 to 9 weeks. Half of the deaths were due to staph infection, which occurred in patients taken for strangulated or incarcerated hernias. Otherwise, death was attributable to hepatorenal failure. The remaining major complications were hematemesis, requiring transfusion at 2 to 4 weeks post-op. Overall, the author suggested that most patients with umbilical hernia, secondary to cirrhosis, do not require surgery with control of ascites, and that at the time of publication, there were limited reports on umbilical hernia repair in this patient population. Therefore, additional data was needed to comment on the frequency of the problem and subsequent complications.